Me and my husband met when we were small children at a convention at his church.
We were both 9 years old, somewhere around that age. She might have been a little younger because she might have been 8. I was probably 9 because I'm a little older than she is.
I think I might have been 7 or 8 years old. And my mother took me and my sister to a convention at Rehoboth Church here in Vallejo. I remember meeting a young lady, a young little girl that was a member.
Her name was Dion Bernard. And her and Dion were playing.
And this little boy kept running back and forth past the bathroom.
Even though I was 9, you know, she struck a chord with me. I was like, oh, that girl is cute. At 9 years old.
She's like, oh, that's Danny. That's my pastor's son. Being kids of the church, we interacted a lot.
Periodically, I would see her and her sister at all the conventions. Around 17 years old, she knew that I liked her, and I expressed this, and she let me know. We went to McDonald's one day. It was at the Youth Congress, and she says, you know, Danny, I like you. You're a nice person. You know, handsome or whatever the case. You have a nice car. Of course, that would be the values you would have at that age. And, but I just, you know, I don't think so. So I was a little heartbroken.
It was time for me to go to the prom, and I was talking to a mutual friend, and Johan. And Johan said, well, why don't you ask Danny? You know Danny likes you. Call him and ask him to take you to the prom. I'm like, I'm not calling a boy to take me to the prom. He said, okay, well, then I'll call him and ask him to take you to the prom.
He gave me a call, and back in those days, of course, we didn't have cell phones. We had three ways. You remember three ways? Where you could call somebody and put them on hold and then say, hold on. So anyway, he called me. He says, man, Camille Galbraith want to take you to her prom. Want you to take her to her prom. I said, what? Are you sure? I thought he was kind of playing a joke because he knew that I had tried to talk to her earlier that summer, and she said no. And he said, yeah, I talked to her on the phone, and we're going to call you tonight because we had Sunday night service. We'll call you tonight. I was like, all right. I thought he was, you know, joking. Sure enough, he called, and she was on the three-way. She was on the phone and asked me to her prom, and that's how it started.
We started dating in 88, and then we got engaged in early 91.
We dated for 3 years. Yeah. From 88 to 91.
What drew me to Danny, I believe, is because we had the same upbringing, we had the same beliefs, and I knew even dating as a senior and even considering who might be my husband, even as a young girl, I knew he would be a great match. Someone who did love God, someone whose parents raised him, almost identical to the way my parents raised me, I knew it would be a good fit. Danny popped the big question to me at dinner.
We were in Osac. We went to some steakhouse there. I don't know what the name of it was.
Very, very nice restaurant.
It was for her birthday. She thought I was just coming to have dinner with her to celebrate her birthday, but I had already bought this ring.
He had a beautiful ring
that it took months to pay for. So I thought I was gonna kind of play a little practical joke on her. So I brought in this fake ring. During the course of the dinner, opened up the little box and said, I would like for you to be my wife. And she was like, oh, Danny.
It was funny, because the folks around us in the booths and in the tables around us kind of caught wind of what was going on, being nosy. And so they kind of cheered for us. It was nice.
She put it on and she was looking at it. And I was looking at her and she was looking at it. And then I said, no, that's a fake ring. Here's the real ring. So I gave her the real ring.
I remember the day he came to the house and said, I'm gonna ask your dad, can I marry you?
It was very important for me. I was very traditional. It was very important for me to ask the father. Approaching her father to ask her could I marry her? Was one of the toughest things I've ever done in my life. I remember being at their house and telling Camille, tell your dad to come talk to me in the kitchen or the dining room.
Dad was in the kitchen. He's like, well, you're gonna go in there with me? I'm like, I'm not going in there. So go ahead and do what you gotta do.
We sat down at the table and I said, you know, I really would like to marry Camille. I don't exactly remember what he said, but whatever he said was that, oh, that's good. You know, you're two young people and it's a good thing to marry. You know, with us being Christians, we believe in marriage. And basically gave me the blessings to marry her.
August 10th, 1991. It was a beautiful day. It was a super 100 degree hot day in Sacramento.
My family reunion was going on. And so I had like, I don't know, probably close to 100 family members who were in town.
We married at Hillsdale Boulevard Church, right outside of North Highlands.
I remember we were all there waiting for the buses to arrive. They were all bussed in. And it was almost time for the wedding. And they weren't there yet. And my mother was a part of was one of those that was on the bus, and my father. And I remember her mother saying, we're gonna have this wedding regardless of who comes. I said, oh, no, we're not.
His father married us, and his father had performed hundreds of weddings, or lots of weddings. But you could tell his dad was very nervous. That was his baby boy getting married. And so the ceremony itself was a little slow, because Pastor Jefferson was a little nervous.
We had unity candles, you know, those are traditional things. I believe we had 10 groomsmen and 10 bridesmaids, so it was a large wedding party. Reception was out of sight. It was what is now called Lion's Gate. At that time, it was the base, and it was in that same complex.
The Officers Club held 500 people. And we had to open up a second ballroom because in those days, people didn't respect RSVPs. You just sent invitations to everybody's church and whoever came, came.
We went to Hawaii for our honeymoon.
It was a gift from Danny's godparents.
Our wedding was on Saturday. We stayed in a hotel on Saturday night and Sunday night because our flight was first thing Monday morning to Hawaii.
We stayed right on Waikiki Beach for a week, and it was fantastic. Then the Lord blessed us with three children.
Morgan Danielle, our first child, born in 1993.
And she's fantastic. He really wanted a son, but it was a beautiful, beautiful baby girl.
She was just an adorable little girl, full of life and full of just, you know, cute.
Born in 97 was his namesake, his father's namesake, Perlis.
Every man wants a son. And so it was quite significant when he was born. We was excited about him, just as we were excited about Morgan as well. And, but we had a namesake. It was important for me to have a son because even though my brothers, I have two brothers, none of them had boys. They all had girls. So there was no one to carry on the Jefferson name.
Then came Janelle. Janelle came in 99.
Janelle Carroll, to be exact.
She was such a handful. We always said we would have four children, but after Janelle, that was enough. It was a wrap.
She has been a tremendous blessing. She's the life of the party. As most young, you know, the younger siblings. She's a little leader. She's a little bossy.
How have we stayed together? By the grace of God. To God be the glory.
You know, I would say that what I would hope that I have instilled personally is that when you make commitments, that you keep them, and that when you get married, it should be for life.
Our commitment to God helped us to sustain our commitment to each other.
It should be something that you're not trying out, I hope it works, but you stay there, and you stay there through the good times and through the bad times. You know, when we made those vows, we said for better and for worse, for richer and for poorer, in sickness and in health, till death do us part.
It was love. It was him loving me, me respecting him. Love and respect definitely has held us together.
If there's anything that I hope that we have conveyed or I've conveyed is that tenacity, that stick-to-itiveness, no matter what, you know, in the end, things pay off when you stay together.
It is absolutely a choice. Love is not just emotions and feelings. Marriage is not just emotions and feelings. It is a choice. You choose every day that I'm going to love him or her, I'm going to respect him, and I choose, no matter what happens, we're gonna stay together. It's a choice.